Good morning, everybody. Shavua Tov. Wishing you all a good beginning of the week. I hope you all had a wonderful Shabbos. And, of course, a happy Mother's Day to all of our mothers and all of the Jewish mamas out there. Thank you all for being so incredibly wonderful and important in our lives. A big thing happening this week. Tomorrow night, Monday night, is the holiday of Lag BaOmer, Monday night and Tuesday. Now, what is Lag BaOmer? There's a lot of different pieces to this. The one thing I want to focus on, try to get everybody thinking about, is the fact that this is an important day because this is the day that the plague, which was destroying the students of the great Rabbi Akiva, ended on this day. And his students stopped dying, and therefore it's a day of celebration. We've been mourning up until this point. That's why we have the long beards and the scruffy hair. We haven't been cutting our hair because it's been a period of mourning for the students of Rabbi Akiva. And on the day of the 33rd day of the Omer, that's when his students stopped dying. I want to talk about Rabbi Akiva. In fact, I'm going to dedicate this entire week to telling you about Rabbi Akiva, because he was one of the most important people in Jewish history. Now, the first thing I want to tell you about Rabbi Akiva is, think about this. He is probably the most important person in the Talmud. The Talmud, the repository of all Jewish knowledge and wisdom and Jewish law, Rabbi Akiva is mentioned almost 600 times in the Talmud. And in fact, the Talmud, which is the explanation of the Mishnah is the writings of Rabbi Judah the Prince from the notebooks of the students of Rabbi Akiva. I know that may have been a little bit confusing. Don't worry about it. A little bit of a history lesson. But the Mishnah, which is the oral Torah, was written down by Rabbi Judah the Prince from the notebooks of the students of Rabbi Akiva. Rabbi Akiva was one of the great, great, great sages of all times. And you would think that somebody who played such an important role in Jewish history, who was the Talmudic sage of all times, would have this great illustrious lineage, would descend from great rabbis and scholars. Well, guess what? Not at all. His father's name was Yosef. His father, Yosef, was a convert to Judaism, and he himself was a descendant of a Canaanite general. So you may be wondering, how did this individual, Akiva, who, by the way, knew no Torah at all whatsoever, had no Torah knowledge until he was 40 years old, how did he become the great teacher and sage of the Jewish people, Rabbi Akiva? And the answer to that is because there was somebody who believed in him, somebody who saw his incredible potential and believed that he could be great. Who was that? That was Rachel, or Rachel. Rachel was the daughter of a very wealthy man, and Akiva was the worker in their house. He worked in the stables. And Rachel saw Akiva's keen mind, and he saw his diligent work ethic, and she saw something incredible inside of him, and she believed in him. And she said, Akiva, I will become betrothed to you if you agree to go and learn Torah. Rabbi Akiva knew nothing. He had never studied Torah at all. He said, how am I supposed to study Torah? I'm 40 years old. She said, I believe in you. It's the power of having somebody else who believes in you. I'm going to tell you what happened in the rest of the story tomorrow. But for now, just know that the great Rabbi Akiva became who he was because somebody believed in him. And it makes us realize that for us, we have to really tell the people in our lives, our children, our spouses, our parents, anybody, friends, we believe in you. You're amazing. There's so much you can do. And make sure people understand that and communicate that to them all the time. I just want to make sure everybody knows we have something incredible coming up at L'Chaim Center, an Israeli Distinguished Speaker Series beginning a week from today, next Sunday, starting with one of the most fabulous speakers that I know, Flor Hassan, and she is amazing. She's the deputy mayor of Jerusalem. She's going to tell us all about what's going on in Jerusalem these days, the future of Jerusalem, where it's going. You really don't want to miss it. Pay close attention to the emails, and there'll be a registration link, and you can sign up. Everyone have a great week, and happy Mother's Day.